good evening again. As I said earlier, my name is Amy Mays. I am not the typical director that is in front of this group. Unfortunately, Mr. Pizarra has come down with the flu, so I am filling in and taking this as we go. So anyway, the group that you see before you is Wind Ensemble. This is our top performing group here at the at Union High School, and it is a privilege to get to spend any time with them. The piece that we just played for you is a piece called Gavorkna Fanfare by Jack Stamp. And for our next piece, we're going to play two movements from the second suite by Gustav Holst. We're going to play the first and third movement. But to conduct this piece, we're going to bring out our student teacher, Mr. Thomas Boardman. Please welcome him to the stage.
Thank you. Nearly 21 years ago, on April 20th, 1999, tragedy struck the town of Littleton, Colorado, when 13 innocent lives were taken in a mass shooting at Columbine High School. More than 20 others sustained physical injuries, but the damage report for that day goes far beyond a body count. The entire country reeled in shock at the events of this day as we watched in horror and grieved at such a barbaric attack on our way of life. The pain and aftermath of such senseless violence cannot be quantified, but to simply say that this day left its mark on American history would be an underselling of its significance. Evil showed its face that day, and our country was forever changed. In response to yet another painful moment in our history, the assassination of John F. Kennedy, renowned American composer Leonard Bernstein shared some words that we believe we are appropriate for a moment like this. He said, "We musicians, like everyone else, are numb with sorrow at this murder, and with rage at the senselessness of the crime. But with this sorrow and rage will not inflame us to seek retribution. Rather, they will inflame our art. Our music will never be quite the same. This will be a reply to violence. This will not be a reply to violence. To make music more intensely, more beautifully, more devotedly than ever before. And with each note, we will honor the lives of those we have lost." An American Elegy by Frank Tekeli was written as a tribute to honor the lives of those who died on a fateful day. But above all, it is meant to be an expression of hope, one that will allow us to find healing, love, honor, and respect within our common humanity.